welcome. You're watching Education News Network, where we get you the latest developments in education at the top of this hour. Today on this forum, we're going to discuss a very important topic about challenges and opportunities in online education. For this, we have a great team of panelists who are going to join us in this conversation. Let's welcome our first educator panelist for the evening. We have Mrs. Meenakshi Zarabi, who's the executive principal of Aspen Scottish School in Noida. She comes with a rich experience of 26 years in education. She specializes in strategic planning, curriculum development, and parent engagement. She has been the award winner for the most inspiring educator awarded by Dr. Kiran Bedi.
Thank you, Vibha. Thank you. We are lifelong learners, and every day we need to learn. Online education is another platform to learn.
Our next panelist for today is a dynamic leader, a completely people's person. She is none other than the principal of Evergreen Senior Secondary School, Delhi, Mrs. Priyanka Gulan.
Thank you, Vibha, for a generous introduction. Thank you to Education Today and Mr. Anil, you for inviting me for this panel. Most sought panel discussion, I would say.
Let's welcome our next panelist, Ms. Yasmin Pirzad, who is the founder, trustee, and principal for the Bellwood Springs School, Mumbai. She's also the territory head for Early Childhood Association in Mumbai. Let's welcome her.
Hello, Vibha. Thank you so much.
Our next panelist for today is Dr. Kavita Sinha, who's the principal and head of school of Nalapad Academy, Bangalore.
Thank you so much, Vibha.
We have Dr. Gayatri Devi with us, who is the principal of Little Flowers Public School, Bangalore, standing committee member, CISCE board, principal coordinator for CISCE Sports and Games. She is also the executive committee member of the Association of Schools for the Indian School Certificate Examination. Welcome, ma'am.
Welcome. Thank you.
Last but not the least, let's welcome our last panelist for today's evening. She is Ms. Anuradha Rai, the founder principal of Ambience Public School, Gurgaon.
So ma'am, to begin with, we'd like to talk to Mrs. Priyanka Gulati, who is the principal of Evergreen Senior Secondary School, Delhi. Ma'am, what is your take on the challenges and opportunities in online education today?
Good evening once again to everyone present here. It's such a pleasure to meet you all here online. So when we talk about challenges, you know, I'm coming straight to the topic and talking about the topic. When we come to challenges, basically first thing which I feel for the students, as if we see from the students' perspective, the fun in a classroom is missing. The students' interaction, that human interaction between students and the teachers, which is majorly missing when we come on online education. You know, it's very, very, human beings cannot live in isolation. We have to understand that. Thus, human beings cannot live in isolation. And living behind those four walls of a home and having an online classes from home is restricted to those four walls. He is not going beyond. He is not interacting. And that isolates him from the outside world, which is very, very vital for human beings. I also feel that character building is another important point which we need to keep it in mind when we talk about online classes. Character building, when child is coming to a regular school. So in regular school, what is happening is he is basically that imbibing of respect towards teacher, imbibing of respect toward their peer group, imbibing of respect toward, and love, of course. Love is a major bond which a human being is known for. So the love between human bonding, which they develop with their teacher, with their peer group, and most above all, the respect which they give to their Aya Didi and to their sweeper Bhaiya, that is missing from where that character building will be done when they are behind those four walls, inside those four walls, I would say, of their home. So human, again, when I talk about human being, development of human character, then it comes to sensory organs. How do we develop our sensory organs? I'm going a little fast. So how do we develop our sensory organs? Sensory organs can be developed only through interaction, through the feel, the emotions which they share, the feel, the touch. They are playing in basketball court. They touch, the touch of a basketball cannot be felt at home. That volleyball cannot be felt at home. Then meeting there, giving those high fives to their friends. Can that be done at home? I really don't think so that can be done at home. It is very, very, very vital that they go out and develop seeing. Like at home, you're just seeing, developing your sensory organs with those four people in house, you know? Whereas when you meet outside, go outside, you meet so many people. So what do you see? You meet so many people outside. You meet your friends, you inculcate certain habits, take certain habits from them, give certain habits, give your certain nature to them. That's how we become a holistic being. That's how we become a human being. Otherwise, we are not a human being. We could be like any animal. We are social animals. That's what makes us different from other species. So online teaching, when we talk about challenges, then these are certain challenges. Of course, internet disruption, which we were facing just now, all of us we were facing. So that's another issue, major issue. Then, yes, if we talk about eyes, physically they affect our eyes. If child is studying online for 3 to 4 hours, if I'm not talking about 6 hour schoolings, but 3 to 4 hours, if he's sitting on a computer, definitely it is going to affect his eyes, which is of course no way is good for a child who is still developing and his physiology. Then another major challenge I personally feel is that smart students are basically native to technology. So when we say that the smart students, they can fix their screens, you know, they can fix their screen and teacher will not get to know that child has vanished from there. So that eye to eye contact, where child teacher can see exactly what child is, she can read, she's trained to read child's eye. And she can see that when child eyes, when she sees that child is getting little dissociated with the class, he is not inside the class, but his mind is roaming somewhere. She uses different techniques, you know, immediately storytelling, she switch over to the storytelling or collaborative exercise, maybe clapping, maybe just a jogging at the place. They are doing on online classes also, but then that kind of integrity in the class is, I personally feel, is missing. And I would say that we learn from each other. We develop with each other. So that is majorly when we talk about challenges, that development cannot happen in online classes. Opportunities, I was thinking, so I couldn't find many of opportunities because I'm not the computer person, basically. I'm much more toward the, I'm more like a heart-to-heart, connecting heart-to-heart person. That's what kind of a person. So probably that is the reason I couldn't find much of opportunities. But I personally believe out of adversity comes the opportunities. So by learning, teachers are learning. So I would say this opportunity is more for the teachers. So when I'm saying students are native of online education, or we can say online on internet. So teachers are basically immigrant to it. So now what they are doing is they are learning new tools, developing their, completing their reality, I would say. So when they're completing their reality, they are learning new tools, developing, they are becoming also internet smart. So that is, I would say, is a, during these challenging times, they are learning to develop. Another point which I could find was freedom from geographical boundaries. Child can access online education sitting from at a very distance place, and still he can study and be in touch with his teacher, talk with his teacher, and be in touch with his friends also, even if he's sitting at a distance. Maybe he's sitting at Bangalore, and till he is able to connect with sitting right in Delhi. So another one point which I could get is that child become more responsible here. So responsible in the sense that that kind of a monitoring which teacher gives in a classroom is not there with the child sitting monitoring at home. So child has to take us honest on himself of doing his work. Though teachers are taking with Google Classroom, teachers are taking assignments, they are checking assignments, everything is happening. But that speed, that quality, obviously, is missing. I personally feel, that's my feeling, that I'll see what other panelists have to say, but that's my personal feeling, that is somewhere missing. So one thing towards the end, I would like to sum up with 2 points, that one thing which I foresee is after the moment our digital classrooms are over and we are back to regular schooling, students as well as teachers will respect more of human existence in togetherness. That's what I personally feel, that the moment we are going to go back, we are going to respect our colleagues, we are going to respect students, are going to respect students, and teachers are going, teachers are going to respect students, vice versa. So that's what is, I personally feel, is going to happen once they go back to school. So that's a major advantage. So to me, if I have to sum up, I would say that online schooling is like a caterpillar who could never get wings to fly. Whereas a regular schooling is the students are like butterflies taking their wings and flight. Thank you very much. That's all what I have to say.
Thank you, ma'am. On that note, we move on to our panelists.
Move on to our panelist, who's the principal of Ambience Public School, Gurgaon.
Thank you, Vibha, and thank you, Priyanka, and hello, everyone. Well, I want to turn it around a bit, and I would like to start with opportunities. So I would like to say that the first thing is that despite, you know, so this lockdown was not created by us, but, you know, everyone has risen to the occasion. And what I love is that learning hasn't stopped, and we have, you know, everything else has been locked out. Schools haven't, the learning hasn't been. So you've closed the schools, but the teachers have, and my children and my parents and everyone. So I want to start with that it has been a beautiful opportunity. I mean, something, the first time when we discussed this, my teachers were also a little, scared, because, you know, like this was something like, you know, they hadn't really done at this scale. But amazingly, the teachers have, found that strength within and created such beautiful, and innovative inquiries and, you know, exercises, which would help. In fact, I feel that in some way they are doing even a better job because, you know, they are so conscious of it. And just this morning I saw FA that they were planning. You know, it was interdisciplinary and it was very relevant and was connected with the corona pandemic. So I said, wow, look at them. And, you know, the kind of work that is coming from the children too. So you see, in the classroom, what was happening was the teacher, even though we say she's a facilitator, the whole thing was like, you know, still teacher driven, even though we were following inquiry. Here, I see the shift. I see, like, I think Priyanka also mentioned that, you know, right, even if I see whether from the student perspective or the teacher's perspective, the creativity is coming out and they are taking responsibility for their learning. So I would say that has been a great, shift, so to say. And then to add to that, I think the parents. So you see, yes, there are issues, but the parents have realized that how tough it is to, you know, what the kind of work. So the kind of feedback I get from the parents that, oh my goodness, I didn't know that you guys did this and we didn't even know this is how you taught. I think that again, and then, you know, they are sitting sometimes and seeing, and they said, oh, we didn't know this is how it is to be taught. Oh, thank you. You know, so we do have those parent sessions, but not so kind of extensive. So I think that has also been a big plus. And the new upskilling teachers are learning. And, so all those, I would say, the pluses and the opportunities. However, as Priyanka mentioned, you know, so learning is always in a social context. And we don't send children to school for literacy and numeracy. The children are going to school for, the other skills that are built, negotiation, interaction, collaboration, problem solving. So whatever you may try, that, the just being together and doing things, I mean, we are trying our best, but it's not the same thing, I would like to say. Then the other thing is, of course, technology, but I think that's a small part. And then increased screen time is something I would say. And more importantly, you know, when you are physically present, you can see, you know, the body language, you know, the, those non-verbal communication that sometimes gets missed when the children are on screen and, you know, somebody's trying to raise a hand and with so many little Hollywood squares, sometimes you might not be able to, you know, what should I say, connect so well, which we could do in school. So, yes, that is a disadvantage. But again, I want to say, you know, it is about, you know, finding. So this was not out of choice. But then I want to salute all the teachers and all the educators for rising to the occasion. And I think this is one sample or one, what should I say, model that can teach the whole, you know, world, you know, how to. So we did not get defeated. We taught anyway, and we've just carried on. You know, undefeated. So that is what I love, and I want to clap and salute all the people, all the educators for doing that. And thank you for putting, you know, this panel together and for us to be able to discuss. Thank you, Vibha. God bless you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Our next panelist for today is Dr. Kavita Sinha, and she's the principal and head of school for Nalapad Academy, Bangalore.
Good evening, everyone. It was really great pleasure to listen to Priyanka and Anuradha. And I was thinking, Anuradha took the words from me. I would rather talk about opportunities. Nalapad Academy being a tech-savvy school, we took this as a great opportunity to connect the dots between the teacher, parent, and the child. The problem is we are trying to look at into a very minute problem saying social interactions cannot happen. We did come up with a plan where we did a flipped learning and teaching where social interaction walls were broken. We talk about collaborative learning, and I think this is the best place where you can do a lot of collaborative learning and a lot of hands-on learning can happen with things which are available at home. The challenge is to connect with the parents beforehand, give them a plan, lay down a classroom-like atmosphere at home, which some parents are able to do. Some are working from home. They have some issues. One laptop at home, how to share the time. Second is, can we have 40-minute class? I think so. That's very unreasonable. You need to break down your class to max 20 to 22 minutes, give them a break, as we did in March. We started with pranayam, some breathing exercise. Give them a break. Have 20 minutes of lesson. Do an interactive worksheet, which we had sent beforehand, you know, the printouts, everything was done. Watch the child doing, because they're small, they're young. You need to keep telling them.
Teacher and the student.
All three have never in life worked so much in one line the way they're working now. Parents want to give them a learning atmosphere. Student is excited with the new equipment on his head, their earphone, and teacher is equally excited because they have been trained by IGCSE, I should say. I'll thank them for the lovely webinars and the training they have given. So it was a very pleasant, I can say, shift to online training without much up other than the technology which fails at times. Otherwise, if you ask me, if you like to keep a learning environment inside the home, then this is a very good platform. But we cannot have 6 hours, because some parents did complain from different schools saying 8 to 2 they were having classes. Now that I think is not advisable. What we did for primary, we had 2.5 hours class with 22 minutes class with break of 8 minutes. Again, come back as a peer learner. And not more than 4 or 5 people on a screen at a time. So we did actually a rotation of classes a lot. Maybe because we are small in number right now, we were managed to do it. But then even I tried with my higher classes. This online training has been, teaching has been more of a learning process, has been very high. Opportunities has been high. Teachers are now getting very skilled in using different apps, which they had never done in their phone or in their iPad before, to actually download and know about how to make an iMovie. So most of my teachers in 2 months have become great experts in making, creating iMovies. And they have been doing a great job. And I would like to thank, I would not like to take much time because other speakers are waiting in the panelists. But I would say, Vibha, this was a great opportunity to meet so many of them. And if we can share our email IDs and we can share our, you know, whatever we are doing, this is the best time to share technology and best practices, because we need to help each other and gain from each other so that we can sustain this as long as COVID-19 is thinking to stay. That's my last two words, that let's take it as an opportunity. And as principal, I'm very happy because I am able to see what I cannot see while moving into the classroom. I'm able to see each and every class what's happening. So that way it's a good experience and a very nice opportunity you have given. So I'd like to thank Anil Sharma, Education Team today, and Vibha for you for getting this done at such a short notice. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much. That was a wonderful talk from you. Next, we will move on to our next panelist, Mrs. Meenakshi Zarabi, Executive Principal of ASPAM Scottish School, Noida.
Yes, Vibha, I was listening to all educators and I feel they're all talking our language because we all sharing the same story, sharing the same life, online life. Now, this has become an online life for all of us. Yeah, it's a real, I feel education has become a real, it's a pedagogical shift. You know, I was just talking to Kavita that the teachers are no more sages on the stage. They have now become the mentors by side. See, all these challenges, what they faced, bandwidth, you know, parents not, you know, kind of crewed up with this, teachers not crewed up with this, teaching the teachers, training them, getting children into the fold. All these challenges were with us also. Then the opportunities, yes, we created loads of opportunities through this. Like rightly what Kavita said, she enters into the classrooms and, you know, does a sneak peek and learns through. You know, while I was observing the teachers while they were trained and from initially we started from Zoom and then we did on Teams. So we found both the platforms really, you know, kind of wonderful. With Teams, we used a lot of tools. Then we created our own learning management system wherein teachers use 60 tools for planning, differentiation, you know, kind of when the instructional deliveries are done. Then we also did assessment lately, you know, assessments also. So those multiple question assessments, even small summative assessments were projects, all those things we, you know, we also undertook through this learning management system. But the biggest, you know, kind of a little challenge where we faced was when children were, you know, kind of had to be trained for cybersecurity issues. You know, we really realize that children are getting into more experiential. They are more experiential. It's their place. It's their native, as rightly said by Poonam. So we had to make sure that parents are sensitized. They, with the smaller children, the parents sit along and security issues are taken into. We took a training for the parents also to tell them how to use the tools safely and how to make the best use of, you know, online education. For the, you know, elder lots, we had to, you know, kind of create certain restraints of muting, email etiquettes, you know, raising hands, kind of debarring them from annotations, slide shares. All that were, you know, kind of challenges which we faced apart from other things. But slowly, as now it has become a new rage, the children, the students, the parents, the teachers, and the management has started enjoying it. And thanks for the opportunity that God creates out of every, you know, kind of, there's a small opportunity in everything and we need to make use of those opportunities. I think the best has been said, so it's just the little additions I made on this platform. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thanks for your input. Moving on to our next panelist, we have Mrs. Yasmin Prasad, who's the principal, founder, and trustee for Velvet Spring School, Mumbai. Ma'am, what is your take on this?
See, Vibha, thank you very much. First, I would like to thank you to bring us all on one platform where we are sharing the same opinion and everything. But I would like to, you know, add something to whatever, you know, our panelists have said. Now, when we are looking at, the opportunities, my heart goes out to those children who do not have access to technology, do not have access to the tabs and, the mobile, if they have only one mobile at home or something like that. We are blessed that we are, running an IGCSE school and we have all these and we can immediately take up. Within no time, when the Janta curfew was declared on 22nd of March, we were up and running with all that we could do best for not stopping learning. We wanted learning to go on and we could do it. By April, we were all on with our activities online, online teaching, our assessments. We used, a lot of platforms for assessing children. As in, parents were keen about evaluation and all that, although it does not, go very rigid with the IGCSE curriculum. But yes, when parents are keen, we went with goformatives.com and we went assessing the children and we put in a lot of activities. We put in a lot of, things where they could. So we were doing all this. But at the same time, when I had my neighboring schools who were, not able to do certain things. So there we have to understand that when we are talking about challenges, we have to think about something where this is a technological wave which has gripped us, which has taken over us completely. As you are talking 100 years back, if you talk about 100 years back, when we had professions like the blacksmith and the potter and everybody, and then suddenly we had this industrial wave taking over. Then everybody was running to the industries and machines were the talk of the town. And, we were not there at that time. But yes, we have learned our lessons in management and history and all those things. So we understand that the industrial wave had taken over the world. And now it is the technological wave. So there's nothing but, either you get into it, jump into it, start swimming, or you get drowned.
Absolutely.
You get drowned. It's simple as that. Yeah. So then, yes, when you talk about opportunities, definitely no chalk and talk. We always went around telling our teachers, we do not want that mandatory thing where you are just teaching and, there has to be some creativity and you'll get outdated and all those things. And then actually that has happened. The teachers become all of a sudden overnight very creative. There are no boundaries. Out of classroom experiences have come in. It is, when you're talking about opportunities, technological, whatever changes have come in, we are, it is a window to the world. I would say it is a window to the world. The world is your classroom. We have global citizens participating. We have children on a global platform where they can explore, they can learn, they can do so many things. So all this is there. So long and short of it, when I'm talking about opportunities, learning does not stop. So we have proved that learning will not stop, come what may. Hand in hand, parents, teachers, management, all are working together, upgrading themselves. There's a lot of creativity. It is very convenient. It is at your house was neglected all these years. We have been running between ends that, okay, school, whether, if it is annual day at school or some big event at school. Yes, of course, a little bit at home is neglected. Now what has happened is you can do both the things. You can balance it so beautifully. Okay, women are known for multitasking and they are actually doing it. They're doing it. They're managing offices. They're managing their house kitchen also. The kitchen is just a stone throw away. You can pop into the kitchen, sip a cup of coffee, yet get back, and do a lot of things. So it's very nice, I feel, when it comes to opportunities. Yes, when it is talking about challenges, lot of pressure on the teacher, where as management, we were just, giving them instructions. And ordering them or calling them, telling them, it has to be like this and it's not fine and all that. But when it comes on the teacher's shoulder, she had to face a lot of pressure suddenly when she had to move into the technological wave. When again talking about challenges, there will not be any emotional bonding if online learning has to stay. No connect between the teacher and the child. Today, we always hear teachers saying that, what is success to us? Success to us when a child grows up and, when they come back to us and they are, they still remember us. They still remember us. They come back and say that, ma'am, you were like wonderful. I cannot forget you. You are my best teacher or something like that. So that would have been our success. But right now with online teaching, this is surely going to not be the case. So our success mantra has to change. Then no emotional bonding. Yes. The EQ, the CQ, the emotional quotient, the creative quotient, will be largely missing. Parents will be there always to help the children. So we will not know the creativity. We will not be able to tap talents. It will be difficult. We will do it, but yes, it was going to be difficult where you had that little classroom where the teacher could make out instantly that, okay, this child is very good. This child is going to be a very good reader, or this child is going to be, you know, a scientist or something like that. We could immediately make out what the child is good at. So that's going to be missing. Yes, what about working parents? When parents are going to leave for work, when this lockdown is lifted, have you thought about it? What is going to happen? Will the child be left alone with the screen time? The child has to, you know, then they will explore anything and everything where we were putting all bars on. So we'll have to take care of that. Cyber security, cyber ethics, everything has to come into the picture in that scenario. Lastly, I would just like to sum up where, as all the other principals mentioned, again, no social interaction. Everybody is not tech savvy. So all these things have to be there. Lastly, the summing up would be that if we do not upgrade ourselves, we will get outdated. So we have to upgrade ourselves to this new wave and go with the flow as of now. Yes. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Ms. Yasmin. On that note, we'll move on to our last panelist.
Gayatri Devi, who's the principal of Little Flower Public School, Bangalore. Welcome, ma'am. What's your take on this? What do you have to say?
The challenges are immense. Like all the panelists this afternoon have spoken, the challenges are immense. The teachers are coming out of the comfort zone of the four walls within the classroom and exposing their teaching abilities to the entire world. When I say the entire world, yes, of course, the students plus their parents and plus a lot of armchair critics who are going to just point fingers and say that she could have done it this way or that way. So, I mean, a teacher has to be aware of all these pros and cons and forget about everything, because for me, a teacher is someone who is passionate about his or her work. So be passionate, put in your best, and show to the world that, yes, this is the way ahead. Yes, Vibha.
Ma'am, we just got to know that since we've seen schools, kids are always bullied by parents. The teachers are being bullied by the parents. How true is this?
I just read this shocking article on one of the daily newspapers, and it's indeed shocking. And I think a teacher shouldn't quit just because the situation demands it. We have seen all forms of bullying, and this is one new kind of bullying where teachers are being mocked online. So I think it's as a teaching fraternity, we need to send a very strong message to the parents, to the children, that you need to respect her for what she's doing. You need to understand that it's a 45-minute class in a regular classroom, but the same 45-minute class turns into 6 hours or 8 hours of preparation before they go online. Like one of the panelists just mentioned, that our teachers have not seen a break this summer. They are working March, April, and now we are in May, and continuously they have been working to enhance and hone their skills, and at the same time, ensure that children are meaningfully occupied during lockdown. So, I mean, our scriptures say that, you know, we need to respect our guru. I think it is time that we do it in reality for the world to see and appreciate what the teachers from the Indian fraternity are doing today under lockdown.
On that note, ma'am, Dr. Kavita Sinha, we'd like to know from you. These days, it is talk of the town that the teachers are being bullied by the parents because of they not being tech savvy or digitally not very good, since schools and classrooms have digitalized overnight because of the pandemic. Teachers and the schools are still coping up with the facilities and the classes and all of that. How true do you think is teachers being bullied by a parent true, or how are the teachers facing this? Ma'am, we can't hear you.
This is a scenario whenever we have a new product coming in. Me being from a business management background, I'm trying to tell you, online teaching is a new product. There will be people who will criticize about it. There will be people who will be bullying about it. I tell my teachers, train yourself, be confident, stop taking heed of what people are saying, do what is your job. Because no parent can actually keep more than 60 days their children. I get mails every day that, ma'am, when are we having our online classes resumed? When are you resuming it? When is it happening? That clearly shows that teachers are very powerful community. We need to just upskill our skills, what we have, upgrade our skills. We need to be a little more patient and take criticism with a pinch of salt. There could be some kind of faltering you're doing. Learn from your mistake, but don't give up. We should not give up. And I can tell you, teacher community is very resilient. They will learn faster because they are born with this, to learn and unlearn and again learn. So I think we should not pay heed to any of this bullying. We should just go on.
Absolutely, absolutely. Moving on to Mrs. Yasmin, what do you think, Ms. Yasmin? How is it hampering the teachers? Are parents really bullying the teachers on a digital platform?
The news article was really sad when we read it today. But then we have to understand that teachers are working very hard. And this is the new normal. This is the new normal that we have to accept. So if there is something where, you know, nobody is perfect, nobody is born perfect. So if there is something which we need to learn, and this is the new trend, so teachers are making so much of efforts. They're putting in so much of their talent and, themselves. They're putting themselves in. So then parents have to respect this. And they are upgrading ourselves. So I have been telling my teachers that you have to upgrade yourselves, otherwise we'll be considered outdated. So in the same way, this is a new normal. The parents have to accept it and they have to understand that, yes, we have to give that little respect which the teacher is due. She is due that respect. You have to respect that, and at least that effort has been made and things are there. But I think this would be like a 1 in 100. It's not everywhere. We have so far not faced anything like this, touch wood, and it's nice. It's nice where parents are very open to it. And as Kavita ma'am also mentioned that, you know, they are looking forward to these online learning and everything. So even my parents and my children are like looking forward that, ma'am, when are we starting again? And when are we, what is the timetable? And do we sit with our uniforms on? And things like that, you know. So it's very nice. So I don't think that this should be repeated. Everybody should learn a lesson from what has happened and take it forward from there. Yeah.
Moving on to Meenakshi, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, in fact, the parents understand that we are being receiving a lot of appreciation mails from the parents.
Ma'am, we can't hear you.
In fact, the other side of the story is, apart from one odd, you know, kind of incident, which doesn't need a mention, not much of a mention, but on the other hand, we are receiving a lot of appreciation mails from the parents. Parents understand the hard work, the, you know, strive the teachers are, you know, making in kind of delivering the online education. They understand it's not so easy, rightly said by ma'am, that it takes at least 2.5 hours of preparation to deliver 45 minutes of classroom. And they also sit besides the children and they find out how much of effort a teacher is making. It's not easy to, you know, kind of engage children on while they are, online education. It's very difficult for teachers using all kind of tactics, all kind of engaging tools. They're using PPTs, they're using stories, they're using, you know, kinesthetic methods. They're using health and safety measures. They're, you know, kind of creating an environment which is engaging for the student. So they need to be appreciated at all times. One or other case can always be ignored. But whatever is right, rightfully teachers are doing that. And they should be appreciated and applauded for every effort they are making. Because it's for the first time also, such kind of strenuous efforts they are, you know, putting in. So they have to be appreciated. Yes, such cases need to be ignored, and let's motivate our teachers. Let's, you know, kind of have team meets. Let's tell them on daily basis. At the end of every session, we meet our teachers every day and we tell them today, you know, this is what went right and these are the areas of improvement for the next days. So that also can be dealt at the management level or at supervisory level, so that teachers understand, you know, daily reflection. And then there's a scope of improvement for everybody.
Absolutely, absolutely. Thank you so much, ma'am. Moving on to Mrs. Priyanka, we'd like to know from you that there are digital classrooms everywhere, every school is conducting it. But since initially when kids used to come to school and there used to be regular classes, that time we used to have that one naughty child in the class, which is very difficult to grab attention of the child for a teacher. So when the child is remotely placed in a different location and where the child is not physically present in front of the teacher, how difficult is it for the teacher to actually teach such kids, to teach that one particular naughty child in the class?
So interestingly, that one particular naughty child is still a naughty child. So it is difficult, I won't say, for simple reasons, because a child who is there in a classroom, he is still behaving. I have a habit, I enter in classrooms also. I enter in these digital classrooms and observe students. So one child, teacher, it's for difficult for teachers to observe them on a screen, all 40 students. We have a class of 40 students. So it's very difficult for teachers to observe on a screen all 40 students. So I found that one child was doing some origami work. Teacher was teaching, he was doing origami work. Another child could be scribbling on a screen, you know, when teacher was sharing. So this was, I would see that teachers found out the way they basically learned how to monitor. So now once they are equipped with it, they know that this is a naughty child. So they pick up, ask him questions. They ask him question. He's taken suddenly for this thing. And then obviously he has nothing else but to answer. He knows that he'll be caught. So that naughty childs are always in a target list of whether in a classroom or in a digital classroom. They're always in front of the eyes of a teacher. So asking a question, asking him to be leading on in a flipped classroom when a child is supposed to take a class. So he doesn't have much of a choice, but then if he is given allotted a duty that you have to explain velocity to a class, he is born to listen to the teacher. So that flipped classroom concept, and we sometimes do certain activities, collaborative activities. So those bring them back to the classroom, basically. That's what it is. And teachers are becoming more tech-savvy now. So when they're becoming more tech-savvy, then they have learned also how to monitor those naughty students with technology as well. Thank you.
Absolutely. So Dr. Kavita, what's your take on it? What do you have to say? How do teachers deal with that one naughty kid over an online classroom? Ma'am, we can't hear you.
Vibha, we are also an inclusive school. So I also have special ed school students as well as I have naughty kids. And that's the reason it's a lot of planning which we have done, that we are trying to rotate our class to a small screen time and also to have focus on just as 4 or 5 children at a time and do the classes in rotation. You have in physical classroom is 2 sections, but online you move to 8 sections. It's a lot of planning for the supervisors and the coordinators because you need to keep rotating your class. And when we tell naughty, I would say all children are naughty. And for that, there's a lot of work which has to be done. Are we not naughty? My question is how to keep them focused is a very, very difficult task. And this is where we want the teachers to innovate and bring in creative ideas. And we tried something which I would like to share. It was a very simple experiment. Lab was away from the school. I mean, they were at home and the teacher had to teach something to do with, you know, oxygen and carbon and things like that. So they actually created experiments which were done in the teaching environment. There the naughty kid gets occupied, the kinesthetic basically kids. Another very bad expectation of a teacher could be to expect the child to sit and learn. There we have to be flexible. We need to give at least a 3 feet radius. A 3 feet radius for the child to move around. Please do not expect grade 1 to grade 4 children to sit on the table and chair and have your classes. Not happening, because when they are in school, they keep visiting the washroom. So you have to bring in those practical aspects that yes, here also they need a break. Secondly, we had also sent a letter with code of conduct for the parents to stop that bullying nature. Of course, the parents will sneak in. We had said we want a live classroom at home. So please arrange your small area in your home, which looks like a classroom. And it was an exercise given to the parents. So some of them were over enthusiastic and they actually created a board and you know, where they could pin up some posters and things like that. I think if we are more open to our parents, we can tide over the situation. But if we are closed, then this will not help. We have to be more transparent to our parents and also take their suggestions and do things where they also feel that they are part of the classroom. Don't keep them away. If you keep them away, then they start targeting. They start finding problems in the lesson. But if you bring them in, you can manage the naughty kid also. I think that's my 2 bits about it.
Thank you so much, ma'am. That was wonderful listening from you. Last but not least, Dr. Gayatri, I guess you had a question for the panelists. Can you come up with that question? We are running short of time. We have like last 5 minutes.
Yes. I do understand. My question to all the panelists would be, you know what kind of parents are in your school. You have all sorts of parents. Someone who is very proactive, who comes to school for every parent-teacher meeting. And you have some who are parents who remotely monitor their children. So do you have any formula to weigh these parents on the same scale and to give them a platform where they are only mute spectators and not keep harping at every given opportunity? Any tips on that, panelists?
We do have some cases. Mm-hmm. We do have some cases where parents don't even bother to switch on the Zoom meet and they say, ma'am, we forgot, we got up late. So we tried doing something, a reminder message at half an hour before my coordinator sends through Edmodo. Edmodo is a very good tool where you can send bulk messages, bulk mail, and give them a reminder saying, we expect you at this time, very politely. Some of them tried to skip it, then very politely we took their classes, and as you know, we kept haunting them that you have to do it. But I can tell you there's no 100% methodology in this. You have to try different methods to bring these parents. There's no 100% guarantee that these parents really support us.
Thank you. Yes. So much. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. All the panel.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, everybody. Nice.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, all the panelists. It was lovely talking to you all, and I'm sure you guys have enjoyed this conversation.
Thank you, Education Today, for this opportunity.
It was a pleasure for us also. Thank you so much, Vibha. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
On that note, we come to an end of this wonderful session on challenges and opportunities in online education. I'm sure you guys have loved this conversation and debate as much as I did talking to all these esteemed panelists. For more such panel discussions, stay tuned to theenn.com. Do not forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. This is Vibha Raj signing off.